Hopping on you with the pick and roll. Younger Flame, he in sicko mode.
Hi, this video is the summary of lesson learned of Corporate Finance or Executive MBA program at IFMI International Business School by Professor Roy Semple. Let's check the mind mapping behind me. It is definitely useful. If you want to learn more detail, let's join our class.
This is a mind mapping of corporate finance. We will go into detail for each topic. Intro to financial management. Objective of this course, to give the students problem-solving skill in finance from the point of view of management and investor. Goal of financial management, basic objective, operational objective, social objective, and research objective. Basic objective will result on significant and sustainable value creation. What to manage in corporate finance? Capital structure, working capital management, asset structure, revenue management, cost management, cash flow management, growth management, and risk management. Corporation and financial market. There is a link between them. For corporation to buy or sell the financial securities that involve investor on the process, this activity is done for corporation operation, and taxes of this activity will go to the governments. In doing corporation operation, sometimes there is a principal agent problem. It is the problem between shareholder and management as agent due to number one, conflict of interest, number two, asymmetric information, and number three, moral hazard. Some action need to be done to eliminate this issue, such as good selection process, appraisal refer to the KPI, and do internal audit. Good corporate governance principles. These are transparency, accountability, responsibility, independence, and fairness. Four cornerstone of corporate finance. We learn about the number one core of value principle, number two conservation of value principle, number three the expectation treadmill principle, and number four the best owner principles. Time value of money. The time value of money is the concept that money you have now is worth more than the identical sum in the future due to its potential earnings capacity. This core principle of finance holds that provided money can earn interest, any amount of money is worth more the sooner it is received. Capital budgeting. Capital budgeting is the process of making investment decision in long-term asset. It is the process of deciding whether or not to invest in a particular project, as all the investment possibilities may not be rewarding. On the capital budgeting, we need to understand about the cash flow. There are initial cash flow, outlay, operating cash flow, and terminal cash flow. Capital budgeting method, there are payback period. This advantage of payback period ignores the time value of money, neglect cash flow received after a payback period, ignore a project's profitability, and does not consider a project return on investment. Net present value, the project accept if NPV is bigger than or equal to zero. Profitability index, the project accepted if PI is bigger than or equal to 1. Internal rate of return, the project is accepted if IRR is bigger than or equal to required rate of return. All three methods above consider all cash flow, time value of money, and required rate of return. Analysis of securities. So, fundamental analysis is a method of measuring a security intrinsic value by examining related economic and financial factors. The end goal is to arrive at a number that an investor can compare with a security's current price in order to see whether the security is undervalued or overvalued. Framework of analysis by looking at the domestic and global economic analysis, industry analysis, and company analysis. On the company analysis, we need to understand about financial statement, understanding financial ratio analysis, and understanding DuPont analysis. Suppose we need to understand about healthy or unhealthy a company, we need to check the ratio analysis and then the DuPont analysis, and then comparing with other industry that have the same business. Technical analysis is the forecasting of future financial price movement based on an examination of past price movements. Technical analysis can help investor anticipate what is likely to happen to prices over time. portfolio theory, we learn about the variance, correlations, beta stock. Beta is an indicator used in measuring the sensitivity of a stock to overall market movement. If a stock has a beta 1, then its movement is in line with the market price. If the beta of stock is less than 1, then the sensitivity to fluctuation in price movement can be said to be lower than market price. Beta measures the risk of the stock systematic relative to market price movement. Capital asset pricing model describes the relationship between symmetric risk and expected return for assets, particularly stock. What is the risk? Total risk consists of systematic risk and systematic risk. Unsystematic risk can be eliminated by diversification the assets. However, there is systematic risk. It is risk that cannot be eliminated through diversification, such as macroeconomic and political factor. Systematic risk is presented by beta value. The goal of the capital asset pricing model formula is to evaluate whether the stock is fairly valued when its risk and the time value of money are compared to its expected return. On the portfolio investment, we learn about the personal financial plan with the same principle, save and invest then spend. Capital structure. The capital structure is the allocation of debt and equity that a company uses to fund its operation and expansion. Companies tend to seek to optimize their capital structure to achieve flexibility and a healthier and stronger financial condition. Optimizing the capital structure means that the company must achieve certain financial ratio value that reflect the effect use of debt and equity for the company's survival. A benefit of debt financing is that interest is tax deductible, whereas payment to equity provider are not. But debt financing has consequences of obligation to be paid to creditor, no matter what financial condition of the firms is. Hot issue, we learn about the sovereign wealth fund. It is a state-owned investment fund comprised of money generated by the government, often derived from a country's surplus reserve. SWF provide a benefit for a country's economy and its citizen. Corporate restructuring. Due to the financial distress, corporations need to take action in surviving and transforming the business. We learn about the LBO case study. LBO is a leveraged buyout. It is the activity where, say, a company A want to buy share on a company B. Instead of buy all share by their own cash, company A would buy share company B with small portion from public shareholder, and then the remaining public shareholder will be taken over by company A through debt issuing by company B. How does it work? Once company A buys small share of company B, then company A will get approval from shareholder of company B to manage the next action to issue debt on behalf of company B, with cash flow and asset from company B as collateral. Then debt will be used for funding of taking over the remaining of public shareholder to be owned by company A. Then the company B will be single shareholder and become private company. By doing this, then the capital structure of company B will be changed to be more debt exposure. LBO would be benefit being done to target company who has high profitability and healthy cash flow. More debt after LBO would have the tax benefit for target company. Fraud risk management, we learn about reason for fraud, early warning signal, and how to prevent fraud. Issue in finance, we did the lesson learned by watching movie. International finance, derivative markets. Derivative market is the financial market for derivative financial instrument like future contract or option, which are derived from other forms of asset. The primary purpose behind derivative contract is the transfer of risk without the need to trade the underlying. This allows for more effective risk management within companies and the broader economy. In addition, the derivatives market plays a role in information discovery and market efficiency. Forward contract is an arrangement made over the counter between two counterparties that negotiate and arrive on the exact term of the contract, such as its expiration date, how many units of underlying asset are represented in the contract, and what exactly the underlying asset to be delivered is, among other factors. Forward settle just once at the end of the contract. Future, on the other hand, are standardized contract with fixed maturity dates and uniform underlying. These are traded on exchange and settled on a daily basis. Future contract that obligate the parties to transact an asset at a predetermined future date and price. The buyer must purchase or the seller must sell the underlying asset at the set price, regardless of the current market price at the expiration date. An option is a derivative contract that gives the buyer the right but not the obligation to buy or sell the underlying asset by a certain date or expiration date at the specified price or strike price. There are two types of option, calls and put. Arbitrage is the simultaneous purchase and sale of the same asset in different market in order to profit from the tiny differences in the asset listed price. There are three types of arbitrage: locational, triangular, and interest rate. Dividend policy. Why company pay dividend? The reason are, number one, dividend payment is tax deductible to investor. Dividend is signal. Regular dividend as indicator of consistency company in value creation. Number three, dividend being paid due to the agent cost.